What's going on, my PT peeps and my Walking Dead family? Welcome to the PT channel. I'm One Eye Bri, back to talk about a variety of different things. So just wanted to mix it up a little bit, put a face with the name. Some people don't know what I look like and they're like, whoa, that's what you look like. Can't believe it. I can't believe it. So I do live streams every Sunday. I'll be doing one this Sunday for, we'll talk about episode 909, 910, the back half of season 9, and a bunch of different topics. But the following Sunday, I won't be able to do one because I will be on the Walker Stalker Cruise, the final Walker Stalker Cruise. And so live streams, 1 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. I'm in Florida, so that's when I have a good time to do it. And I just want to talk about a couple of different things in this video. First and foremost, my book series. Some people like it. A lot of people love it. Some people hate on it and they don't read it. But this is book 9 right here, Settlement. It's book 9 of my series. I have ideas for about 20 books. So I have book 10 come out in October later this year, and that'll be the midway point of the series. And it's a great thing because it's creativity. It's something that I wanted to do for a long, long time. And with that being said, I have a reputation of just talking about The Walking Dead. Well, I am not just a Walking Dead YouTuber. I am a doctor of physical therapy. I have a bachelor's degree in exercise science and a minor in psychology. I'm a homeowner. I'm a husband. I'm a cat owner. I'm a bunch of different things, but I am a Walking Dead lover. I love the universe. I love the comics. I love the story in general, but I'm a creative person. I like to draw. I like to create things. That's why I'm a YouTuber. I'm a creator on YouTube. And I always had the idea of a zombie apocalypse book series that was kind of centered around, loosely based, of course, about myself, my friends, my family, who would be alive, who would make it, who wouldn't. It's going to be ups and downs. It's going to be a roller coaster of emotions. And it's just a fun thing to do. People are going to hate on it because that's what people do nowadays. People hate anything that's successful or is liked by other people. People love The Walking Dead, but a lot of people hate it for the simple fact that people love it. People are just going to hate on it too. So with that being said, I have some advice, really life advice, I guess, if you will, right? But any authors are out there, I recommend this. Work at your craft, write every day. If it's in a notebook, if it's in, you know, actually typing something up on a Word document, and just put your train of thought down on a piece of paper or somewhere like that too. I always have a notebook around and I write different things in there too. Something pops in my brain and I'm like, okay, yeah, this should happen, or yeah, that should happen. And then it comes back to me when I'm writing, it just gets into my brain, or I reference my notes and there it is, right? So I recommend that you use, you know, a Word document or some sort of word processor, because initially I had just the free Word processor and it wasn't good. And then I tried to switch it over to Microsoft Word and it was this whole big thing. And that's where I ran into a lot of problems. And, you know, it just was rushed because one, I got into the hospital right when I was kind of wrapping up the book. And I was in the hospital for like four or five days. And I was like, I got it. Should I wait? Should I not? You know, and I just was in the hospital for hours on end and just, you know, going stir crazy and had to do all these tests. And, you know, it was just a big mess. And I should have waited, but I rushed it out. And rushing it out wasn't the best thing. So another piece of advice is don't rush it out. Wait, edit it, check it, have someone else check it, and then check it again and see if you're happy with it, and then release it. Because people aren't gonna know your struggle. They're not gonna care what it took for you to write it, what you were going through. You know, if my book series is on Amazon for like the next 5 years and people are buying it in 5 years, they're not gonna know what I went through when I wrote it. They're not going to care. They're going to care what the story is on the paper. And I understand that. And when I was writing it, I was just trying to get it down and I was trying to get it started. And people were enjoying it. And after looking back on it, it was rushed. It was not the best copies. It was not the best editing. There was always mistakes on it and there too. And just to clarify, I went back and I edited it. And I can change the file and I can go back and edit it. And I have. I've gone back and edited the first 4 books because they needed to. I need to go back, take my time, and just make it done right. So if you're going to check out the book series, it should be good to go now. And I have a sequence now that works and it's good. And it's one of those things that I have it down now and I use, you know, Microsoft Word. I write it. I go through and edit it. My wife edits it. And then I do it one more time. And I got little tricks and things that I use. And it's a way better process. So that's my definitely words of wisdom, is write your ideas down, get a format that works for you, and edit it, write it, edit it again, and do it. Don't stop. Take breaks if you need to, but don't give up on it. It's sometimes tough, and it's easier for me to write because it's loosely based about my friends and my family and myself. and it's in around Tampa Bay. It's, you know, it's a fictional Tampa Bay. It's not the exact Tampa Bay, but it's the future, and it's one of those things that it's just easy to write because I'm driving down the street and something pops into my head when I go past a hardware store and I'm driving down the road and I'm like, just like living it. I get into the zone and I'm living it. And there's times where I've gotten emotional writing it, you know, big things have happened and, you know, I've been upset when I had the right things, but it makes sense. If I don't get upset and if I don't really feel it, the readers won't. If the writer's not feeling what they're writing, the readers have no chance of feeling any great emotional ups and downs and big moments. So it's okay to do that. And we are human beings and we have emotions for a reason. And they're actually necessary when you're writing and you're creating art and books and whatever you're doing. And hopefully you find inspiration and motivation in, you know, our YouTube channel, my YouTube channel, you know, on Facebook, Instagram, all that stuff, because it's all connected. Social media, our YouTube channel, our Facebook page, our Instagram page, our Twitter, everything like there. Because I'm trying to inspire and motivate. And some people don't need it at all. Like, I don't need motivation. I'm a self-motivated person. I've been that way my whole life. But not everyone has had that chance or the opportunity, or they're just not built that way, which it's all right. Everything in life requires work, hard work, effort, help, people being there for you to support you, right? And there's times where I wanted to give up on things, especially when people are just been rude in the comments, and you're gonna get that. So if you're gonna start a YouTube channel or start anything in there too, expect the haters to come out in droves. And you know, I block people and I just hide their comments and all that stuff because I got zero tolerance for that crap. People are going to hate on some hard work that you put into. They don't care. They don't care all the hard work you put into doing it, the hours, finding the information, or you know, drawing, or whatever you're doing in life, writing, or you know, editing. It's just one of those things that people don't know what it's like. They don't know. They just love to hate on things and run their mouth and just talk crap because that's what people do. So if you're gonna start a YouTube channel, be prepared for the haters because they're gonna come out in droves. They're gonna be ready to attack your channel if they even see it, because a lot of times it's tough on YouTube to really get noticed. I've been on YouTube now for over 4 years. At the end of January 2019 was 4 years. I have 2,002 videos on YouTube. With this upload, it'll be 2,003 videos. And I think that's a lot. It's probably low compared to some channels and way more than other channels, but it is what it is. And you know, the PT channel started off as I'm a physical therapist. So I was like, let's talk about fitness, personal training, physical therapy, talking about, you know, ailments, rotator cuff, back surgery, back injuries, neck injuries, knee stuff, this, exercises. I have a pretty cool home gym. You can check out the video on the channel, and I've updated it since then. And I think it'd be kind of interesting to learn because before you go to YouTube for something funny or how to do something or just, you know, video games or whatever you were into, you know, funny videos or workout videos or learning. So I want this channel to be about education, entertainment, having fun on a variety of topics. So the future of the channel is bright for, you know, the future. I'm talking about The Walking Dead, my Fight for Us book series, movie stuff, you know, a bunch of different things. Next week, I will be on the Walker Stalker Cruise, the final Walker Stalker Cruise, and I will have a bunch of videos for you guys. I love to share what I see and what I do, and then I'll work on all these different videos of putting it all together, a compilation stuff of all the fun events that I've had at the Walker Stalker conventions, the cruises, just around Sonoy and a bunch of things, because not everybody can be there. And I try to be there for you guys to share it with you. It's a community feel, a Walking Dead family. If you love The Walking Dead and just being entertained, this is a channel for you because we like to talk about a lot of different things and have a little fun escape here. It's my channel as much as it is your channel, and we try to bring you things that you and I both want to talk about. And I'll end the video on this, right? I'm a gamer. I grew up in the 80s with Nintendo, Super Nintendo, playing Street Fighter in the arcades and all that stuff. You know, I was pretty good at Street Fighter. I grew up playing it a lot. And I recently looked into getting one of those emulators or something around there too, and a classic NES and a classic SNES, and playing Street Fighter and everything. But I was really excited to play Zelda again and Contra and all the old games. And I was talking to my dad about playing Zelda, and he got excited. He was like, oh man, yeah, that's great. I remember playing that. And, you know, I had my old NES controllers back at his house, so we had to mail them to me, and we started talking about Zelda and everything there too. I bought an adapter for it and got the original NES controllers for the system, because there's nothing better than that. And I was playing Zelda, and my dad got really excited. You know, Contra, Zelda, Mario, Mario 3, all that stuff. It takes you back. There's nothing like old school gaming at times. So my dad got really excited over the phone talking about Zelda, and he goes, yeah, I remember playing Zelda, and it was this. And I had the Nintendo in my bedroom. That Nintendo for the longest time, and my little like 13-inch TV. It was terrible, but we had a Nintendo and a TV, and life was great in the late 80s, early 90s. You know, like, yeah, man, I can play video games in my house. That's like the best. So I was playing it, fell asleep, went to sleep. Next thing I know, I wake up in the morning. My dad is in my room on the floor trying to be quiet to play Legend of Zelda, and he's like playing and he's doing this, and I wake up, I'm like, man, how long have you been there? He's like, I don't know, man. I'm just trying to beat this level. I'm on level 4 now. I'm trying to get this and, you know, this sweet sword. And I'm trying to do that. It was so funny because he was playing all night and was in my room and trying to be quiet. And it was just pretty funny. So The Legend of Zelda takes me and my dad back into the days when I was growing up. So I'm going to be doing some more gaming videos. I had a couple on the channel, but I just recently rented the Resident Evil 2 remake for PlayStation 4. I'm a PlayStation guy. So I rented the Resident Evil 2 remake from Redbox, and I got a 3-night rental for $7. So I'm like, I'm going to rent it before I buy it, because I've been burned on some games, and I'm like, I'm not going to spend $50-$60 on a game that has no replay value and it's not worth it. Well, I like Resident Evil 2 on PlayStation 4, but I would try a rental first, because I beat the Leon and the Claire, you know, modes, mode A, you know, the first run, and I played the second run on both characters, and you can beat the game in a long weekend with Leon and Claire, but there is replay value to play the fourth survivor. You know, you can play Tofu, you can play this, they got some DLC content going on there too. I'll probably buy it down the road, but I'm going to have some of the videos now. The files are just really big, so I'll show you some of the gameplay, and the, you know, the capture card was lagging a little bit, so I got to go through it. And it's a big ordeal. The gaming files are a little bigger. So I'll be talking about that plus a variety of things. But let me know your thoughts in the comments. Post your comments below what you would like me to talk about more and more and more. And I'll definitely make some videos about it if people want to do it. Also, last live stream, someone came up with a good idea to talk about my Fight for Us book series for the people who want to talk about it. I can do a live stream over the summer when The Walking Dead's on hiatus. I'll talk about it for sure, because there's a lot of people that like this series and want to talk about it, and I don't really have the avenue here too, or I'll make a couple of videos, Q&A stuff on there too, but I think a live stream would be good because I could talk about it more and more and more. So I'll be doing those down the road. I'll have it clearly marked, Fight for Us live stream, so people who want to read it, and, you know, hopefully you're up to date with the book series, so you're not going to, you know, be, no spoilers and that stuff. I don't want to ruin anything for anybody because it's my baby and I love it. So thank you guys for watching. I truly appreciate it. Like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. And remember, guys, with hard work, dedication, belief, and sacrifice, you can truly achieve your goals. Believe in yourself. You can do it. It's about love, support, staying positive, and making memories. And see you guys.